All right, you guys seem to want it. The second part of this video. Now, if you haven't watched the first part, look, you could watch the second part and then watch the first part. They're not really in order, but getting to the point of this video, the three remaining services out of the six that can make you 100K a year with your social media marketing agency. These are very juicy, very untapped. We're not going to be talking about the typical, you know, social media marketing agency service like Facebook ads and social media management. And look, we want to cut through the noise, right? We want to have an agency that cuts through the noise, that is on the edge of innovation, that beats the competition, that looks nothing like the other thousands of agencies that never get any results for their clients or never really sign a client. And so these services are part of what's going to accomplish that for you. And so without further ado, I'm going to be jumping deep into the services, detailing what they actually are, what they entail, how to make it work, and the pros and cons. And so by the end of the video, and having watched part one after this video, you can go ahead and select the service that you want to pick for your social media marketing agency. So let's get right into it. All right, so the fourth service that you can pick for your social media marketing agency is copywriting. What is this? Essentially writing words that sell. Okay, so copywriting can be used for the ad copy that we write for ads, or it can also be used for landing pages. The third service that we talked about in the first part of this video was landing page creation. And I talked about the importance of having a high converting landing page. Now, part of that is not just where to place the buttons and, you know, how to structure the funnel. It's also about making sure that you have high converting copy on that landing page so that it triggers people's emotions, right? It can tap into their pain points. It can get in there. It can hook them in, right? And it can get them to take action. So pros, again, we've got a tangible return. At this point, if you watch part one, you probably know that I'm big on tangible returns, because as long as you have a tangible return, as long as you can tell your clients, hey, look at this number. Numbers don't lie, right? I'm making you money. I'm making you a lot of money. Then they're probably going to keep you around and you're going to continue to make quite a bit of money for yourself, right? And so it's got a tangible return, because if you write copy that sells, then that could increase the conversion rate. And again, an extra 1% conversion rate on a landing page or an ad, right, could mean thousands of new visitors, of new customers for that brand. Now, a few of the cons. The first one, and look, it's not as big of a deal as you may think it is, but it is a bit higher, you know, it is a bit higher barrier to entry. And what I mean by that is, sure, you can outsource this, you can outsource this, the service, and there are copywriters that could absolutely crush it out there, right? But it's also typically a service that you have to exhibit with your outreach and sales, right? And so what I mean by that is, if you're reaching out to a client and you're selling copywriting, the first form and mode of selling is going to be the email that you write, the message that you write. And so you can spend a lot of time crafting these emails and crafting these messages and crafting your video audits, right? But you want to make sure that you know a bit about copywriting, because if your email isn't good, then it probably tells me that your service isn't quite good, right? And it's really the only service where you can tell how good the person is just by looking at the email, at the outreach that they send out to you, right? And so I've had a lot of copywriters reach out to me offering their services, and that is the number one thing I look at before deciding to jump on a call or discuss further. How is the copy, right? How is the copy of this email? How is the copy of whatever they sent me, right? Did they hook me in? Did it attract me? Because chances are, if they don't know anything about sales psychology and they cannot hook me in with one outreach email where the whole goal is to hook people in, then they're probably not going to do a great job at my ads or my landing pages, etc., etc. And the final one is that, again, it could have a bit of an overlap with other agency services. For example, those agencies offering paid ads, oftentimes they also do the ad copy for those ads, but again, not to the extent that a copywriter who just focuses on copy, whether it's ad copy or copy for landing pages, is going to be able to deliver. So keep that in mind. Yes, there's a few cons, but again, an incredible service, a high income skill, regardless of what you choose to pick, right? I think copywriting is one of those skills that you have to have up your sleeve, especially in the world that we live in today, where we're all selling something online and typically through the use of the written word. So that is the fourth service, and now onto the fifth service. So the fifth service is direct marketing. Now, this encompasses a bunch of things, and you can offer them combined. I'd recommend you offer them as a separate service, but it comes down to SMS marketing, email marketing, and even chatbots, okay? So essentially direct communication with people who've shown intent to buy from us, or maybe even already purchased from us, with the sole intention of either getting them to purchase again or having them purchase from us. Now, a few pros, first one obviously being tangible returns. So there's a very clear and tangible return, especially with platforms like Klaviyo, Drip, you know, these platforms show you the exact dollar sign attached to any email campaign or any flow that you've created for your client. The second one is probably the most important advantage and pro to the service is the fact that it's literally pure profit. There's no ad spend. There's no money that you have to put behind in marketing. Sure, you have to pay for the contacts that you've got under that platform, but it's all pure profit. So clients typically already have a pretty decent sized email list, right? But they're not tapping into it, right? So it's insanely untapped, which is another pro. And if you can tap into it and move those assets effectively, use those assets effectively, right, to get them to purchase, then you're going to make them pure profit and they're going to be pretty happy with you. Which also means that you could literally work purely on commission at the start, still make a lot of money and still have them keep you around for a very long time because there's no ad spend. There's literally only infinite upside for the client. The only con for the service is that typically it's a bit of an upfront investment compared to other services, but again, that's almost a pro because upfront investment, once it's done, once you've created the copy for the main converting flows, or you know, once you've created the email campaigns for the month, then you just see the money roll in and the client happiness just skyrocket. So that is the fifth service, direct marketing. And now onto the final service. The final service is conversion rate optimization. So you remember the landing pages we were talking about in part one? Well, this service is all about taking those landing pages, right, looking at clients' websites and basically increasing the percentage of visitors that land on that website that then go on to convert into a customer or just take the desired action that we want them to take. Now, if you pros, again, tangible return, right, so increasing the conversion rate by just a few percentage points, that could mean thousands and thousands of extra dollars every single month for the client, and also pure profit, right? So there's no ad spend behind this. It's literally just brain power and taking action on the website, you know, shifting things around, moving things around, right? Changing, you know, the copy on the landing page, for example. But it's only action, right? It's not, there's no ad spend attached to it. And so it's all pure profit. Once it's done. And it's just about monitoring the performance and then making a few tweaks over time. Also, it just means that they're making more out of the traffic that they are paying for, right? And so as much as conversion rate optimization is a service that requires no ad spend, right? They're actually spending money on, you know, most likely they're spending money on driving people to that website. And so if they just get to convert higher, they're just going to make more money out of the things that they were already paying for. But the con is that, you know, it does struggle for longevity. This is a service that maybe you could offer for 3 months, 90 day period, right? Where you go in, you know, make sure that their land pages, websites, everything is just insanely optimized. You increase their conversion rates by, you know, 5% or 10%, whatever your KPI is, right? And then you just leave. You leave them making a lot of money. Then you get your cut. Maybe you can work on a one-off, a unique type of price tag where maybe you come in as a consultant for 20K for 90-day period, and then you get this sold for them and then you bounce, right? But essentially, it does struggle for longevity. It's not really a service that you could offer as a monthly basis. You could try, but that is really the con of the sixth and final service. Again, extremely, extremely profitable, extremely beneficial for clients and for yourself. Definitely an option that you could consider for reaching that 100K per year profit with your agency. And my friends, that is a wrap on this video, but not so quick. If you've enjoyed this video, go ahead and smash the like button. I'd really appreciate it. And if you want to see more videos like this, go ahead and make sure that you hit the little bell icon so you never miss an update. And with that being said, hope you can use these tips to crush it with your social media marketing agency. And I will see you in the next one. Peace.